morning, everybody. I am Dr Nitin Joshi, professor in urology with teaching experience of 25 years, working as consultant urosurgeon in Panvel for more than 25 years. Today, we will discuss the complications and management of androgen deprivation therapy. It is asked in Viva question as well as it is asked in theory paper. The complications of androgen deprivation: 1. Hot flashes or vasomotor symptom. It is the most common and most distressing symptom of androgen deprivation therapy. It is seen in about 50 to 80% of the patients undergoing androgen deprivation therapy. It is a feeling of sudden, intense, distressing, unpleasant sensation of heat in head, face, neck, upper part of the chest and back. So it is the subjective feeling of warmth feeling followed by objective finding of sweating. This is associated with nausea, flushing, sweating. Though it is not life threatening, it is extremely distressing, bothersome, affecting the quality of life, may disturb sleep. It is may be precipitated by the intake of hot food, exposure to heat, stress, change of posture, or can occur even spontaneously. The duration, it lasts few seconds, sometimes even few hours. Frequency, it can be daily or it can be weekly. The mechanism for this hot flashes is that hypogonadal state results into decreased testosterone, resulting into decreased feedback of testosterone to hypothalamus, which contains heat regulatory center. Because of decreased testosterone level, there will be decreased endogenous peptides, namely beta endorphins and calcitonin gene related proteins. Because of decreased peptides, that is beta endorphins and calcitonin gene related proteins, compensatory mechanism of increased endogenous synthesis of catecholamines, which act on the thermoregulatory center of hypothalamus, resulting into hot flashes. Since the etiology is alteration in the hormonal milieu, the treatment aims at reverting back of hormonal disturbed milieu. The drugs which are used are certain progestational agents. The commonest drug used is megestrol acetate. It has got progestational activity. The dose is 20 mg per day, can be reduced to 5 mg per day. Second drug is medroxyprogesterone acetate, which is depo form given intramuscularly. Third, which has got progestational action, is cipriterone acetate, which is actually steroidal anti-androgen. Because of its central progestational activity, it is useful in hot flushes. Started with low dose of 50 mg per day, can be increased to 300 mg per day. However, the side effects of all the progestational agent is sodium retention, water retention, increase in extracellular fluid, and thus aggravation of congestive cardiac failure. Also, there will be increased appetite and hence weight gain. Other drugs are the estrogen supplement, which will be the very effective, very cheap. The drugs which are useful are the low dose diethyl silbestrol or transdermal estradiol. However, it has got cardiotoxicity, that is because of thromboembolic phenomena, high incidence of cardiovascular events, and also because of estrogen effect, there will be painful gynecomastia. The next drug which can be used is clonidine, which has got action of centrally acting alpha 1 stimulant action. Other drugs which are useful are the antidepressant, commonly is the selective serotonin reuptake inhibitor, which is actually the patient of cancer prostate, because of the effect of disease, psychologically they are depressed, as well as because of hypogonadal state there is a evidence of depression, and side effect of hypogonadal state there is a depression, major depressive disorder. And so this drug is effective for control of depression, as well as it is very safe and well tolerated. Next, that is the drug which can be used is vitamin E. It can then gabapentin, as well as tried about acupuncture. Next, side effect is cognitive function. Cognitive function, that is verbal fluency, verbal memory, difficulty in recall of the object, difficulty in identification of the letter, reduction in the visuomotor skill, as well as there will be delayed reaction time. Studies have shown that these patients have got increased anxiety, depression, and even major depressive disorders. And so the antidepressant, that is selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors, that is the drug which is useful for both, that is for the hot flushes as well as the depression, one drug can act for the both. The etiology behind the cognitive dysfunction is fall in peripheral estrogen because of fall in testosterone, and therefore they suggest that hormonal replacement therapy, that is estrogen replacement therapy, may be effective, but the side effect of the cardiotoxicity because of thromboembolic phenomenon. Next complication is anemia. It is normocytic, normochromic. The definition for the anemia is defined as less than 12 g%. Because of decreased hemoglobin, there is a decreased oxygen carrying capacity of the blood, therefore a decreased supply of oxygen to the tissue, causing fatigability. And easy fatigability is the commonest presentation of the patient. This is commonly seen and more worse and more severe in patient who is taking complete or combined androgen blockade. It is seen in 90% of the patients, and this 10% fall in hemoglobin, and the fall starts in even first month of starting of androgen deprivation therapy. The fall in hemoglobin, common is without metastasis, is also because of decreased testosterone level, and decreased testosterone level results into decreased level of hormone erythropoietin from the kidney, and decreased stimulation of erythropoietin precursors in the bone marrow. These patients where the bone marrow is intact, such patient will get benefited by supplementation of injection erythropoietin. However, if there is extensive metastasis, involvement of the bone, that is bone marrow replacement by the cancer, then hemopoietic tissue is affected, and then even injection erythropoietin may not be effective. Now, next side effect is a change in the body mass composition, leading to diabetes mellitus, dyslipidemia, metabolic syndrome, and naturally increased incidence of cardiovascular events. Now, the etiopathophysiology behind that is because of androgen deprivation therapy, there is a decreased testosterone. This results into decreased sensitivity of peripheral tissues to insulin. Because of decreased sensitivity to insulin, there is a compensatory mechanism, that is, there will be increased insulin from the beta cells of islets of Langerhans. Due to this compensation, the function of insulin is stimulation of lipogenesis, and so there will be increased fat synthesis and deposition in the abdominal wall, resulting into increased waist circumference, increased abdominal girth, and even deposition of subcutaneous fat. Studies have shown that there is increased deposition of subcutaneous fat. Overall effect is increase in the fat content of the body, that is increase in body mass index. But the skeletal muscle has got the androgen receptor. Because of decreased testosterone, there will be reduction in the skeletal mass tissue, and so there will be decrease in lean mass. Because of the increased fat, there will be increased aromatase activity, Therefore, the more and more conversion of testosterone into estrogen. So, thus more and more fall in testosterone, more estrogenic effect, more fat deposition. As a result, reduction in the lean weight, increase in the body mass index by fat, because decreased muscle mass, easy fatigability, more tendency towards sedentary activity. Again, there will be weight gain, and so there will be obesity, and obesity is a risk factor for cancer prostate, resulting into progression of the disease. Now, because of the more and more insulin resistance, this will result into altered carbohydrate metabolism, resulting into glucose intolerance, causing hyperglycemia and type 2 diabetes mellitus. Because of peripheral insulin resistance, there will be dyslipidemia, that is increased triglyceride, increased low density lipoprotein cholesterol, and thus the metabolic syndrome. And so, because of this increased peripheral insulin resistance, the risk factors for accelerated atherosclerosis, that is obesity, dyslipidemia and diabetes mellitus, has increased, resulting into increased incidence of the coronary artery disease, myocardial infarction, cerebral vascular accident, sudden death, and thus there is increased incidence of cardiovascular events. The studies have shown that regular vigorous exercise will help to reduce the weight, reduce the fatigability. Because of fat reduction, there will be increased sensitivity of the tissues to insulin, that is reduction in the peripheral resistance. Because of reduction in the peripheral resistance, the main cause for metabolic syndrome is the peripheral resistance to insulin. If that is reverted back, then naturally there will be weight loss, there will be increased sensitivity, more controllable diabetes mellitus, dyslipidemia, and thereby reducing the incidence of the cardiovascular events and improving the quality of life. Next complication is gynecomastia and mastodynia. Gynecomastia is increase in the breast tissue, and mastodynia is tender breast. These two can occur simultaneously or independently. The basic etiology is increased estrogen. Now, increased estrogen can be because of supplementation of estrogen in the form of treatment, which is nowadays in form of second line of treatment, second line of hormonal complete androgen blockade or combined androgen blockade after abiraterone acetate and enzalutamide. Other cause of increased estrogen, where the patient is receiving high dose of monotherapy of flutamide, nilotamide or biglutamide. Common is 150 mg of biglutamide, which is the monotherapy in form of high dose biglutamide, and it is the non-steroidal anti-androgen. Because of blocking the receptors at the target level, it blocks the receptor not only in the periphery, that is the prostate, bone, skeletal muscle, skin, but also blocks the androgen receptor present in hypothalamus and pituitary. This results into the increased synthesis of gonadotropin-releasing hormone, increased LH, resulting into increased secretion of the testosterone from interstitial cell of lady, and so testosterone level has increased. As a result, increased conversion of testosterone at periphery by aromatase enzyme into estrogen, and thus patients who are taking flutamide, nilotamide or biglutamide has increased incidence of gynecomastia or mastodynia. Treatment for this, prophylactically you can give radiotherapy, but if the gynecomastia has already started, then prophylactic radiotherapy is not effective, and then you require liposuction and subcutaneous mastectomy. Well, for mastodynia, you can give tamoxifen, which is selective androgen receptor modulator. The next complication is sexual dysfunction. For normal sexual function, that is maintenance of libido, that is sexual drive and erection, testosterone has got action which is at the central level as well as at peripheral level. Because of the castrate level of testosterone, both centrally mediated as well as peripherally mediated actions have lost, and therefore there is affection of the sexual function. The libido is affected more profoundly as compared to even erection, and this is may be the effect of even psychological impact of disease process. In case of the because of decreased testosterone, even the penile length, penile volume, penile circumference, and even normal nocturnal penile tenutions have also decreased. So for the treatment of libido, there is no treatment for the libido, but for the erectile dysfunction, the medical line of treatment with phosphodiesterase 5 inhibitors or pharmacologically induced erection, that is PIE, or vacuum erection devices can be tried. However, the studies have shown that there is no libido or no erection, then also majority of the patient has hardly any problem. The next complication is skeletal morbidity or skeletal related illness. The most common cause of significant morbidity and mortality in diagnosed case of cancer of prostate is skeletal morbidity. Because of the technical advances, this stage migration, that is diagnosis of cancer of prostate at early stage, and because of the advances in therapeutic modules, there is even the life expectancy has increased even in patients who are suffering from cancer prostate. There is a trend of early institution of androgen deprivation therapy in patient who has localized cancer prostate but high risk stratification. Also, early androgen deprivation therapy institution in patient who develop biochemical failure following radical prostatectomy or radiotherapy, or patient who has got the locally advanced cancer prostate. Overall effect, patient who have diagnosed cancer prostate, there is prolonged exposure of androgen deprivation therapy. Studies have shown that the patient, because of long-term or chronic exposure of androgen deprivation therapy, there is significant increase in skeletal-related events. In patient who has got the androgen deprivation therapy in form of the castration, surgical or the chemical, then even if there is no bone mets, because of the loss of the protective function of testosterone, the significant skeletal related events. The protective function of testosterone is increased osteoblastic activity, that is deposition of the bone, and decreased osteoclastic activity through estrogen effect, and that is dissolution of the bone. So patient who have got the hypogonadal state because of androgen deprivation state results into increased bone loss and decreased bone deposition, resulting into decreased bone mineral density, and it results into progressive fall in the bone mineral density, progressing through the phases of osteopenia and osteoporosis. This bone mineral density is measured by the DEXA scan. DEXA scan is dual energy X-ray absorptiometry, and the osteopenia is a state of bone disorder where there's fall in bone mineral density, which is the score is lesser than normal bone, so the bones are weaker, but they are not as weak as osteoporotic who fracture is in. This particular bone mineral density is fall in the bone mineral density is a surrogate marker for the development of the osteoporotic fragile fracture. The patient with androgen deprivation therapy are about 2 to 5 fold increased risk of development of the fracture, and the commonest sites of development of the fracture are hip, spine, and distal aspect of the forearm. Studies have shown that the patient of cancer prostate, if they develop hip fracture, then they are associated with high mortality rate. The androgen deprivation therapy is also associated with increased bone turnover, that is increased osteoclastic activity and increased osteoblastic activity. The urine marker for increased osteoclastic activity is entelopeptide, while the serum marker for increased bone deposition, that is increased bone osteoblastic activity, is the bone specific serum alkaline phosphatase is raised, as well as increased osteocalcin, which is the protein synthesized by osteoblasts. So the recommendation is that the patient who is going to undergo long-term or chronic androgen deprivation therapy, before starting androgen deprivation therapy, he should have baseline DEXA scan study for bone mineral density evaluation, and after institution of androgen deprivation therapy, there should be regular DEXA scan for determination of bone mineral density, depending upon the T-score, that is the risk of development of osteoporosis and hence osteoporotic bone fracture. In order to maintain the bone health by decreasing the aggravated or accelerated bone loss, there should be lifestyle modification in terms of weight-bearing exercises, stoppage of smoking, reduction of caffeine and alcohol drinks, also daily supplementation of calcium of about 1000 mg, daily supplementation of vitamin D about 400 to 600 international unit per day, and the targeting the osteoclast with the help of medication. The commonest which is used is bisphosphonate. They can be oral or IV. Commonest is intravenously, and that is the zoledronic acid 4 mg, which is reconstituted with 5 cc of normal saline, diluted to 100 cc of normal saline, given as an infusion over 15 minutes. Interval of giving is depending upon the score, T-score on the DEXA scan. It can be 1 monthly, or after every 3 months, or after every 6 months, or yearly. Also, they have suggested even the denosumab can be given, which is a monoclonal antibody which has got affinity for the RANKL, that is the receptor activator of nuclear factor kappa B ligand, which interacts with the RANK, which is a receptor present on osteoclasts, resulting into decreased osteoclastic activity and hence bone resorption. The dose of denosumab is 60 mg subcutaneously after every 6 months. Thank you very much.